They say pictures speak a thousand words. How can you use emojis and little channel icons to help embellish your Microsoft Teams experience? Smiley faces, eggplants, frowns, people with sunglasses. Emojis are indeed little ideograms and smileys that are used in electronic messages, and these have translated into Microsoft Teams. And you can use them to express your feelings, your mood, purvey to people what's going on with you, the little picture, little icon. Now, that used to be, you know, only for people with mobile phones, the trendy young people, but trendy young people are now today's workforce, everybody. So how does this translate into Microsoft Teams? So as we've explained in recent videos, it's quite easy to put an icon in yourself against a team. Now, we all know how to do that. It's quite simple. Click on the root of the team, shall we say, and then go up to the little pencil icon, select the icon of your choice, and boom, you've got an icon next to your team. But how do you do this in a channel? We've got a Game of Thrones newsfeed channel for all things Game of Thrones. So what I want to do is put something a little bit, you know, funky next to it. So we're going to click the three ellipses, select from the drop pop-up menu that we've got, we're going to go to edit this channel, and then using the power of keyboard shortcuts, we're going to hit the Windows key and then the period button or the full stop or the dot, depending on where you come from. If it's America, it's a period. If it's everywhere else, it's the full stop. And then you'll get the list of emojis or emocons, is what some people call them. And there is several you can scroll through, which will add just a little bit of embellishment to your channel. So this is the Game of Thrones news feed. I want some in Games of Thrones. Winter is indeed coming. We'll go with a snowflake, and it puts wherever your cursor is a little snowflake in front of the title. Now, fantastic. Doesn't it make it stand out a little bit more? The pictograph really does highlight this sort of aspect of the channel. So instantaneously, my eyes are drawn to that. Ooh, what's this? Now, that's all well and good, but if you add a new channel, here we go, and we call it Game of Thrones Locations. We then put some descriptive text in there, because that's always good practice to add descriptive text into your channel and your team so people know what they're looking at. You can click on add that channel. Now, at that point, you could have added your emoji, but I tend to add it and then go back in and edit the channel. Press the Windows and the dot button, and then we can select through whichever particular emoji I want. Now, because this is for locations, I think something along like a globe or travel or a map, I think will do me fine. Perhaps not camping. Sometimes you get spoilt for choice and hung up in what you actually want to do. Let's click on the map. That's quite nice because it's locations. Click on save. And again, boom, you've now got another channel like we've got in our Game of Thrones team that depicts Game of Thrones locations and a little pictograph icon slash emoji there. So couldn't be easier. But what about searching for that channel? Well, you might think there's emoji there. What am I going to do? Well, I'm happy to say it works just as it normally would. You click in the place where you want to do an at mention, right? And as we know, if you press the at key, you can get a list of the recent people you've been referencing, but also at and say the first letter will bring up those people who have that letter at the first of their name. So at M gets Megan, for example. At G gets Game of Thrones locations, right? So it works. It still works, even though there's an emoji in front of it, which is really refreshing. And, you know, I think you've definitely got a use for this just to embellish your channels within your team, or even not to do it on every single channel, just the ones that you want to make them stand out. And of course, you can still do the at mentions at and send G A for Game of Thrones locations. Add a message in, where is the closest Game of Thrones location in Dublin, and then hit enter, and everybody who has been added into that team will know or getting a notification that an announcement's been made in that channel for them to look at. Well, there you have it. So that was emoticons or emojis with inside channels. Good little bit of embellishment there, don't you think? So I've been the Collaboration Kernel, and thanks very much for watching. If you haven't already done so, do me a favor and click like and subscribe. And then also check out the bell and ring that bell for notifications. It goes a long way on YouTube. Happy collaborating. See you soon.